All right, so now we're going to try to salvage as much of this geometry as we can so that we can use it on the other side here. But I can already tell that everything in here, all this stuff, is going to need to go away. We've got all these faces here, so probably just clear that stuff out. That thing isn't relevant anymore. Probably easier to just get rid of that. But we don't have to do all this stuff here. And we're gonna have to make some modifications, as we go around this feature here. But otherwise it should be pretty easy. So I'm gonna go ahead and hop into object mode. We'll select the high poly, make it a live surface, grab the low poly, and enable quadra. And once again, I'm going to start with the area that is higher detail. And I can actually see I've got some faceting here. Just it's very subtle. But if I go into shading and turn on wireframe unshaded, you can almost see it. It's not actually as helpful as I was thinking it would be, so never mind. We're just gonna have to eyeball it. Again, we could use a primitive cylinder if we really wanted to, but probably overkill, something like this. And if we look at it and we decide it's too faceted, we can just add more edge loops, and we can use the connect tool and have it respect the surface curvature, and it'll contribute nicely to the roundness. It won't just subdivide a face. It'll actually add a little bit of a tweak to it so that it stays round. Just go ahead and finish this thing up here. And you can see we've got a lot of geo up down here, and then not a whole lot going on in other parts of the blade here. There is a little bit of a curve there, so we want to add that to the low poly. Oops. See if we can get to find this face here. It looks like it's having some trouble, but I bet that'll help it out. We can snap it in. So we go ahead and do that, and then probably start collapsing this stuff in. We don't need to move all those edges there up through the geometry. And we have some vestigial edge loops here that were originally supporting other stuff. We can just kind of begin to see maybe this comes together. I'll hop into object mode for a second. We'll just delete that face. Back to quadraw. Just gonna create some here so that I can collapse them a little bit more dynamically. So in the video, a few videos ago, I said we kind of want to avoid doing that. When you have two triangles kind of terminating at one point, it can be problematic. So I'm just gonna hold Control, and that will allow me to add another edge loop. And this edge here, we could probably just make it a little bit more, just sort of skimming along the top there. Who knows? We don't really want to get too close to that little screw there, I guess. I mostly just want this to be kind of a linear line rather than having some arcing thing going on. We're not really doing a whole lot with that little edge there, but I think it might be worth hanging on to, but down here we definitely don't need it. Just doing some experiments here. That would be possible, but not very pretty. So I think we'll do a. So there we get our two triangles coming together again, which we want to try to avoid. So I don't want to get too close to this grill, though. I guess it doesn't really matter. I can always just fix it. But we have this little triangle there. I think I'm going to avoid that. So these are all quads. This is a sort of a, you see it all the time. If somebody's trying to stay in quads, you'll get these like three quads sort of terminating together, but I think we can get away with something like this. And then I'm just going to even some of this stuff out down here. All right, so now we've got this nice round feature, and we're relaxing it into some more regular geo. Now, what I have here is there's a triangle here, and there's a triangle here. So for the relatively low price of some extra verts, we can actually just quad this out. So that's a thing to kind of keep your eye out for. So I'm grabbing the edge there on accident. I mean to grab that point. So let me kind of show you what I'm talking about. We'll just delete these faces, and then. Go back into QuadDraw. Grab these two. Right, so that was two triangles that were kind of pointing at each other, and now it's quads. So that's just a little bit happier. Again, this isn't distorting, and there isn't a curve in the surface, so it's probably not a big deal if there was a triangle there. But if you can avoid them for not too much hassle, then it's probably worth doing. We'll do something like that too. And we are getting kind of something kind of similar over here. We've got that triangle and this triangle, so let's go ahead and just for the sake of demonstration, we'll show you again. So I'm going to grab all of those edges there, sorry, the faces, back into QuadDraw. Cool. That looks pretty good. This is probably more than we need. I don't know that we really have a whole lot of curvature there that needs to be supported, so I'm just going to collapse that stuff. If I can explain to QuadDraw what it is that I want. It's really sensitive to camera angle as it's trying to figure out what you're doing. So I'm looking at what's going on down here. I'll probably just hang on to these edges rather than collapsing them because I'm going to need to describe some curvature here. So we'll just bring these edges down. I'm getting pretty close here. All right, almost there. Struggling with this one. So I guess I've got an extra point there. So if you hold Control and Shift, you can get rid of the points. And that'll make that a little bit easier for Quadraw to figure out where you want that face to go. Alright, so we're a little bit over 10 minutes. I'm going to go ahead and finish that up and then probably do another speed run here on the back. So I don't think you guys need to see how that unfolds, but let's just do a quick review of what we've got here. So I was able to preserve some of the original geo from the other side, which is nice. I might want to add, you can see that gray stuff there. I just know I'm going to have some faceting back there, so it might make sense to actually just do another little triangle there. But I'll do it with Connect. I'll do that in the next video so that we can see what it looks like when we're preserving that surface curvature. But otherwise, you can see we've got this round thing here. We trim in those edges and preserve that. So yeah, a little bit of a time savings. And we'll go ahead and finish it up in the next video.